going on, everybody? It's me. It's the PRIME coming back at you guys with another episode of the Prime Nostalgia Podcast. And here I am back with Leon Frierson. What's up, man?
Hey, we had to do it again, man. The first one was some, you know, we trying to make it a classic. So let's see what happens this time, bro. But yeah, we back.
Nostalgia. Yeah. Yep, we back with the Prime Nostalgia Podcast, and I decided to, you know, I decided why not just let Leon do some homework, and I just had this crazy idea of creating our own TV block. For y'all who don't know, back in the day, they had TV blocks. They had SNCC, they had TGIF, they had Nick at Night, they had Gas, if you want to count that as one.
Remember they had a UPN block?
Yeah. Ooh, UPN.
Might have to get
we had a Saturday morning cartoons. We had Disney Afternoon. I can name them all. But anyway, yeah.
WB block,
yep,
man.
Yep, yep. We just had a lot of different things that came on different blocks. I mean, I think the most famous one is TGIF, because those just had the biggest shows, and it was on ABC. So I would assume those are the biggest shows, but
I mean, absolutely. TGIF definitely changed the game. If you're talking step by step, I mean, yeah. What else did obviously Boy Meets World.
Yep, we had Family Matters, Full House, like all
all of them. All the killers. So.
Yeah, Sabrina the Teenage Witch at one point. So it had like most of these like famous shows.
I'm gonna just say TGIF. Most of those shows, even though I have mad respect. Maybe one might make it. We'll see. Because they did have Family Matters. That's strong. TGIF definitely just changed, like, the entire game as far as just wanting to be. And that's, like, my 12, 13-year-old years. Those are my formative teenage years. I was watching TGIF. And there's a lot of people out there that had crushes on Topanga, for sure. So that's a common theme. You know, and then they had... What was the black chick? Did you have her on the podcast?
Who?
Did you have anyone from Boy Meets World on the podcast?
Yeah, I did.
Wait, what's her name?
Trina McGee, a.k.a. Angela.
Thank you. Yep. Thank you for educating the people. What was that like?
It was,
Because she was, you know, she was a representative person for, you know, us people of color for a while on TGIF. But in general, like, just... interviewing her would be a dope experience, so that's the reason why I'm asking.
Yeah, well, I'll try to make this long story short. So, she was on a show that was, like, maybe 97% white. It was her, maybe a sound person, and, like, a writer that they hired just for her to, like, study, quote-unquote, black people.
And she made some news about that recently, too.
Yes. She said back in the day, there were some racist remarks. Not that the person was racist, but, you know, when you grow up in an all-white, you know, all your life most of the time, you don't understand that what you say might hurt somebody, even if you're not even trying to make it malicious. But, you know, joking can hurt people. And, you know, when you're like 20, 22, you don't understand that. But, you know, of course, he apologized and all that stuff. And everything's out the way, but... yeah, it was a dope interviewing her. Had a good time. You can go back and listen to that one if you want to. I would give it a listen. It's a good listen. So
I'm gonna check it out because I saw the name after and I was like, "Oh, is that old girl?" Because obviously I saw the news, so I'm like, "Hey, all right, man, I gotta go check that out." So y'all should check it out too.
Yeah, it's a good listen. Good listen. But
TGIF though, but and SNCC, like you said, SNCC. Woo, it was hard. I don't know. We're going to see. SNCC is definitely in my top as far as naming the blocks and, like, trying to come up with a spin. Yep. But I might have went way left with the spin. We'll see later. But SNCC is, like, just the vibe of obviously all that, Keenan and Kel. And we talked about that during our interview. But just the vibe of SNCC in general. And then they had things like Are You Afraid of the Dark and all kinds of stuff. Like, just
kill the
SNCC. Yeah. Oh, man. I mean, classic. That's my guy. Shout out Danny.
Yeah, man, I can talk about these all day. And also this other talk that you said about the crushes. I can talk about that all day, too, but that's another episode. Anyways.
Yeah.
I always, like I do, went overboard. So I decided to look. I was only supposed to do 1/2. I did 5. So
wait, 5 different blocks?
Yeah, I did 5 different blocks.
All right, okay, brother. I got my 1/2, so like we talked about, but yeah.
Yeah. So I'm gonna read my 3 as honorable mentions. Then then we'll go from there. But Wednesday night, the honorable mentions I did not name at all, but the Wednesday night I did a teen block, like just all of teen shows.
Right.
That kind of start around the same age. So like they go for, some of them go for more than 7 years, 6 years, and some of them was like 1 season, but I did it because it's like
wait, you planned out the season? Wait. Let me add some more to my notes. Go ahead.
Nah, cause you know, there's not really shows anymore that grows with the audience, really. Right. Like more than one show. So I kind of see these shows each have 6 or more seasons except for 1. And they kind of grow with the audience in at the same amount of time, whatever. So I call this the teen block. Number 1, the show that come on at 8:00. Is it 8? Yeah, 8:00. Mm-hmm. Wednesday night, mm-hmm. Sister.
Sister.
Oh, classic. Start off strong.
Roger. Roger. Oh, okay, I want to be Roger so bad. Just to be in between the teens every day. Just, please just hate me. I don't care if you hate me or love me. Just let me be there. But yeah, I have the same birthday as the twins, too. Shout out to teens.
Oh, that's okay. Yeah,
July 6th.
That is dope.
But yeah, they, I mean, obviously the show, you got Jack A on there, who is very strong. She needs to make a comeback in a movie or something, please.
Yeah, my number 2 show I have is Moesha. Which is great.
Mo to the A-N, obviously, you know, got the song alone, and then that whole cast is just iconic, too. Aunt D, another one, holding it down. Yep. All the black moms is always holding it down.
Yeah.
Jack A, the Shirley, Ralph. Man, what you got next?
Just because I want to put this out there. I did do a episode with Shar Jackson from Moesha, just to put that out there to the people. If y'all want to go watch that or listen to it, y'all can. It's very entertaining as well.
The real one, too, from the city. Marcus, you got to come do one soon.
Number 3, I got Everybody Hates Chris.
Hey, cause look, I have these people like X'd out on my list, cause I'm like, are we going 90s, 2000s? Cause Everybody Hates Chris is, bro, that's an iconic show. That might be one of the best written shows damn near all time, bro. Like, cause that show, it didn't get its proper respect because I don't think it was in the golden era of sitcoms. And it's not really a sitcom. And I didn't really watch it while it was on. I just started watching the reruns and I just went crazy with it. Like, okay. So, yeah, I wasn't watching really TV when that was coming out. But
my 4th show is maybe the darkest show. Freaks and Geeks. I haven't heard of that. It was a show only for 1 year, technically. 99, 2000. Starred a lot of people that you know, like Linda Cardellini, Jason Segel, James Franco. Oh my God, what is Bill's name? Martin Starr, Jason Daly, whatever. I can't think of his name, but yeah. There's a
name right there. Well, yeah, sounds like a good one, but I haven't seen that one. Go on.
Well, it's more like what can I put it as? It's like the Breakfast Club if they actually was in school, not in detention. I'll feel like. What is what the Misfits?
Well, I'm seeing Seth Rogen on there. Why is
Seth Rogen
there?
Rogen too. Yep. He has an interesting storyline, but you know, especially about a group of friends, group of freaks, group of geeks. It's a good story developing show. I'll call it story developing because most people see it and they'll be like, "Oh, that's a boring show," but it's a lot of story in it. So you know,
a lot of good talent in it too.
Yeah. I got to go through these other ones real quick. I'm going to go through my Monday night cartoon catalog. I'm going to say Rugrats because everybody loves Rugrats. It's a good cartoon.
Oh, yeah.
Hey Arnold. Of course, you got to go with Hey Arnold. Helga, football head. Okay. Number three, SpongeBob because it's SpongeBob.
Ooh, hey, that's one, bro. I ain't gonna lie, bro. I got a lot of hate for SpongeBob. We can get into that way later, but
okay. And
I don't know why I had to bring that. We'll talk about that. But go ahead.
My number four is Rocko's Modern Life. In that,
ooh,
in that.
Strong. Yeah, Heffa. Yep. There's so many. You know what? I was looking at the list of cartoons. There's just a lot of different lists because, like you said, you have Monday night cartoons, and yep, that is a Rugrats type thing. So I was I was looking at Saturdays, and I'm like, this is just a different vibe because I'm looking at like Tiny Toon Adventures and Animaniacs. Yeah, was quite a little different. That's like Saturday morning type. So we'll get into that. That's the future, if you don't mind. No,
that's cool.
You got that one. You got that one.
This is my last one. Then we're gonna go over to some fans, some comments from the Twitter machine. This is Friday night. I went with a friend. What do you call it? It's based around a group of friends. Okay, so
Okay, friend. So a friend theme vibe.
Yeah,
but not friends though, right? No, I'm just kidding.
I gave it a 1B. I gave this like a, this is like 7:30 coming on at 7:30. Right, I did say by the bell. It's all right, cause I'm
saved by the bell. Okay. I like that.
Cause I do, this show is corny, it's coke, it's kooky, it's 90s. I wanted to get that out the way. This is saved by the bell. It's a group of friends, yeah, but it's hokey. So this is coming at the 7:30 spot, right before the main shows.
I mean, can we get into a little bit of Saved by the Bell? So are we talking early Saved or late Belden? Because Belden fell off towards the end, bro. He didn't have no storyline. It was like, oh yeah, he's just getting slapped around in the hallway. Like, what's up with Mr. Belden, bro? He used to hold it down.
And we talk about my favorite. Like seasons, well, I think my favorite like season of Saved by the Bell is the one where they went to work for the beach during the summer. I don't know why, because they just feel like a typical Saturday morning show to me.
And they were still in high school then.
Yes.
Okay. Oh yeah, as long as they was in high school, because the college years, that's when they lost me. I was like, come on, yeah.
Yeah. Then they did the new class or the first class or something like that. That joke went on for like 8 or 9 years. So I'm like, all right.
But yeah, whole beginning. I think I love just the younger years, just like how skinny they were. Like it just crazy.
Yeah.
Like just to see kids like that on screen, especially Screech, and knowing what he went through and what he's doing now. Crazy. But but that's just a little teaser. So what you got next?
My number one or my 8 o'clock show, I got Living Single. So I'm starting off high.
Over 10. Wait, who is the top? Man, there's so much to talk about. Obviously, Queen Latifah, just like her like influence in general, just in hip hop, and then like transforming that to the screen is just nuts. But then you got Kim Fields, who's a LA legend.
Side note. Trina McGee from Boy Meets World said that Kim Fields beat her out for that part. So, You know, yeah, it's interesting. Right. Yep.
Yeah.
My number three, my number two is Friends. No one told you that was gonna be this way. Because you gotta have friends.
Yes, I agree. Friend. Good show. I do follow most of the characters, so yep. I'm not biased or the R word, anything like that. I do follow Friends and watch the show, so I know Joey and Chandler and Phoebe. Yes.
My number three is Boy Meets World. When this boy meets world. This is coming on right at 9 o'clock, and then we could talk about that a lot, so I'm gonna bypass that one. And then my last show is A Different World. It's a different world. Ooh. So
because a lot of people need to watch that one, they haven't seen those classics,
especially that theme song too.
Yeah, oof,
definitely theme song, nice. But yeah, I thought we was gonna quickly go through those people, but I'm sorry, it took a little while because hey, these shows are great. I got a couple comments from a couple people. Ooh, all right, let's get into it. This is from Twitter. Good guy Dave says that my idea is Japan centric, so he likes anime. All right, this is similar to Toonami with the '90s anime movies. And or similar shows to Power Rangers. I'm gonna call it Power Domination Block. Interesting name. Okay, that's cool. This comes on the weekends, and it has Power Rangers, Beetleborgs, Pokemon. I swear I don't know how to pronounce this name. Tenshi Muyo.
Don't ask me.
Yu Yu Hasuko, Gundam Wing, and Sailor Moon.
Okay
so
I knew a couple of those.
Yeah, I heard a couple of them. He basically wants to have like an all Japanese like type of Saturday morning on the weekend, Saturday in general. I mean, I'm not mad at it. That's
I'm into the anime, bro. Like I used to get into more like adult, not super adult, but midway adult anime. You know, not the kid stuff, okay. Sailor Moon. But yeah, my cousin used to put me onto that, so I find it dope. I mean, the stories are nice, and obviously the animation is crazy. And then if you like martial arts, then why not? So I'm into it. Check them out.
So let me see. What's the name? SNES Capades.
Oh, that's my guy right there. You know, wow, you know what's up.
Name.
Super Nintendo.
That is a name right there. Okay. Yeah. He says, all right, I thought about this, but here's my lineup. I'm going to say the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, which is, we'll get into that. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. The Adventures of Pete and Pete, good show. The Wonder Years, which is a good show, of course.
Ooh, you pulled one out with that one. Yeah, I like that. Okay.
His last show is Star Trek The Next Generation, which, if you're not a Trekkie, if you're not a Trekkie, it would mess it up. But if you are,
Do you, are you a, you're a Trekkie? Or?
Nah, I never watched a day in my life.
Oh, yeah, don't watch that one.
I never watched that or the I never watched anything like that, so
shout out to the Trekkies though.
I've been meaning to get into Star Wars, but I eventually will.
We can talk about that too, because Star Wars ain't nothing to really get into if you ain't into it. But all right,
he calls it Suburbs and Spaceships. Interesting name though, because you got the regular show, you got the space shows. Okay, I like it.
Okay.
All right.
We have some homeboys in outer space. That should be on there, too.
Flex is not... We'll
hey, remember, he played MJ. He ended it.
That's why I wouldn't go say nothing about Flex.
I know. I read your mind, bro. Through the waves.
Anyway.
He played MJ and messed it up, bro. We can't even promote him no more. It's real tough, bro. Why'd you do that, Flex?
We have TFGIF podcast, which is Thank Bleeping God It's Friday. 90s podcast. Anyways, they said they created their own SNCC, so they're just going traditional with SNCC, with TGIF and SNCC, so they did too. But the TGIF one is they start off with Full House, then they going over to Sabrina the Teenage Witch, then they go over to Boy Meets World, then they ending at Family Matters, which, I'll be honest with you, that's a solid. That's
fire. Say that. Wait, that was pretty fire. That was pretty fire. I like that one, especially considering their name and their theme. Yeah, I'm gonna have to hit them up. I'm gonna follow them for sure.
Yeah, nah, they are very. They were the first nostalgia podcast I listened to because I was like debating on if I should do anything, like what genre I should do. Listen to them and listen to a couple others. I was like, yeah, well, I should do a 90s podcast, a nostalgia podcast, you know. Shout out to them. I'll hit them up. And then they did another one for SNCC. They said, oh, they gave episodes too. Oh.
Damn. Oh, see, that takes it to the next level.
All right. So they did SNCC. They say at 8 o'clock, it's going to be Clarissa Explains It All. Yeah. And the episode is called Urge to Drive, which is came out in 1991. You'll like this one. 8:30 is all that.
Yes, sir.
Season 3, episode 1 in 1996. Was that? Maybe that's the one where Amanda came in. I'm not sure.
She was season 3.
Yes, so maybe. Because I remember she came on like the first episode.
I think she might have been mid-season though, in season 3, but yeah.
9 o'clock. She says The Secret World of Alex Mack. episode is called Secret, 1995, which is
pretty good. Shout out to Darius Love. I believe that's my homeboy name that was on there, bro. He's still holding it down. Still acting, still doing his thing. Alex Mack was a show, though, right? Is that that's when she used to hit the puddle, right?
yes.
And creep under the door. She used to be in the factories and what was she doing, bro? Like, you got some real adventures to be 12 years old, young lady.
Real. But hey, she was in her own world, the secret world. And 9:30, she says, are you afraid of the dark? Tale of Station 109.1 that came in 1995. So she's going to end it off a little bit spooky for the people. Which, you know, hey, I don't mind that because
I'm a fan.
I think I got it in my cartoons, so I'm not going to even mind that at all. Last comment is from, oh my God, did I just lose it that quick? All right. Last comment is from, she does music. She does music. She just everything, really, but why not have her come in and do something? It's Amy Correa Bell. She says her blog would be named It's Always Amy. Okay.
Okay. About you, Amy. All right. Yep. I see how you think.
It's Always Amy would be the name of her own show. 11 a.m. on Saturdays in this order. Okay. So 11 a.m. on Saturdays. She says, Hanging with Mr. Cooper is number one.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Blossom is number two. Living Single is number three.
Classic.
Martin is number four. And then Boy Meets World is number five.
Five? I would have put that a little earlier, but.
Yeah, me too. Amy got some heat. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, she brought out some names, though. She brought out some names. I like that list. All about Amy. Okay, we see how you think, girl.
Yep. I mean, we might as well go to the song right now. Speaking about all about Amy, you might as well cut to Amy's song. So let's go to Amy.
Yo, what's up? This is Amy Correa Bell, and you about to listen to my new single, Days Like This.
On a day like this, you don't need a sweater. It's the type of weather. Kinda cold, kinda high.
Now is the time y'all been waiting for. The main event. It's time for us to talk about ours. Not my honorable mentions, but just my real. These are my real picks right here. You want to go first, or you want me to go? How you want to do this?
Ooh, I don't know, bro. I got some heat, man. I don't know if you want me to drop these bombs on you, but I'll go first because you already gave a gang of lists. You already told the whole world how you've been thinking. So we have some idea of what you got left. So I want to actually shock the world first and come out with mine. So I got, look, mine is called, look, check this out. This is Lee Boy Magic. Check me out on Instagram, Lee Boy Magic. Yes, Leon Frierson. Leon Lee Boy Frierson. This is my list of top shows that you need in your block. If we're thinking about iconic shows, look. You want me to start? Because you already then gave a gang a list, bro. We already heard your list from Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. You got your team list. You got all this. So I'm coming with my list first. So let me just start this off with number one, which should be number one in everyone's book, regardless of the charges. We ain't going to talk about that right now. But the Cosby Show, bro. Cosby. What from the knee episode to him sewing the shirt backwards to his badass wife and Lisa Bonet. Like, bro, the Cosby Show. I just grew up feeling like that. I wish that was my childhood. I mean, everybody wanted a lawyer and a doctor for their parents, but like the way that he put that together and with the comedy, and obviously he's a comedy god, so that's just obviously number one in the block. But
yep.
What do you think?
I like it.
We already said earlier it might be in yours too, so.
Yeah.
C to the B. I just said Cosby, right? So starts with a C, ends with a B. But Cosby is my first one.
Okay.
And then I got coming up next, Fresh Prince. Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. Because
yeah, we gotta take a pause. Yes, we gotta appreciate the theme song of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. West Philadelphia, born and raised on the
playground is where I spend most of my days. The Fresh Prince, obviously, the cast is just amazing. But I think Carlton might really be like the best like second or like supporting actor ever in any series ever.
Okay.
Is there a better like person that you want on your side than Carlton? Like, seriously.
Well,
In a show.
I have to remember. I have to do a deep dive, but Carlton is up there.
He's strong. I mean, he got his own dance.
Yep.
Yes. A couple of them, actually. We can break down the Carlton dance into about 3-4 dances, and then go talk about Dancing with the Stars. But and then obviously just the whole character, because he's cool. He can sing, and he can dance, and he can rap, but he can also be a nerd, and he could turn it down and he could turn it up and be cool. You remember when he broke his V when he got on the episode when he finally got him a little girl. So he's had some very strong episodes, like very serious episodes. So shout out to Carlton, man. Shout out to Alfonso Rivera.
Alfonso Rivera, yep. Shout out to him.
Mm-hmm. And then obviously you talk about the show like just lasting through the mothers. The light skin and the dark skin mama, like, and then the beautiful like women that Will has had as his, his muses on the show. He's had Vivica Fox. He's had Nia Long. And the list goes on and on.
So, he had Tyra Banks. He had Tisha Campbell. So yeah,
it's crazy. Then third, we're going to turn it up a little bit, but still on the same vibe here of, black leading men, kind of like comedian status. I think I have an affinity for these guys, maybe, but Martin.
Wow.
Martin's crazy, bro.
Wow.
Martin
okay.
is crazy. He, on this list, this is the first time we see a male, like, playing a female. I don't know. Did Will ever do that? Did he ever pull out? I don't think Cosby or Will ever played women in their shows.
No, they didn't.
Shanae-Nay is a very strong character in the episode. I mean, she's the next door neighbor. She's like...
She is a lady.
Oh, she's a lady, you know.
It's her catchphrase, which is funny.
Martin also played his own mama.
Yeah, Mama Payne, yep.
Mama Payne. I mean, then there's Jerome, you know.
Jerome in the house.
And then, I mean, and then just off Martin, you got... Bruh Man from the Fifth Flow.
Yep, Bruh Man.
You got
yep.
Tommy and Cole. You got Pam and Gina.
Yep.
And the list goes on. Like, it just, like, it don't stop. And obviously, he's had iconic guests similar to all of that. So I think that might why I might identify with it so much is because he had the Snoop Dogs. He had the Biggies on there. Obviously, we didn't have those guys, but he had the iconic artists of the time. All coming through the show, so it was like it just was a stamp on culture at that time. So I got Martin in the third slot, and then fourth, bro, Living Color.
How you living? What? How you living? What? How you living?
In Living Color.
Okay, I should have known this is gonna be in your list. Of course. Okay.
In Living Color. So we got Cosby, Fresh Prince, Martin, and Living Color. And just to talk about them, obviously that those are the Wayans. You know. Kenan is a genius.
Yeah.
On that show, you don't know what you're going to get. So, and then, you know, I was struggling with Jamie Foxx, and I'm like, oh, he was on there. So I'm like, yes, I could just throw him in the last slot because, you know, he was doing Wanda.
Yeah. Yep.
And, you know, you got Homie the Clown. You got iconic. We can't even get into that. I can't even think about it. I need to watch some more before I even can get into a real discussion on that because, obviously, you know, you have Jim Carrey and J-Lo's a fly girl.
Yeah. Kim Wayne, Sean and Marlon. Yep.
It's nuts on that show. And then the Wayans. I mean, all the Wayans were on there from Kim to...
Yep. Yeah,
you just said that. Yeah. But,
I think who... Yeah, David Alan Greer was on
David
there, too.
David Alan Greer was on there. And then you had a couple white people. Shout out to y'all. Hilarious people, though. Everybody on that show. Was killing it out the park. And then my block is called So Funny, bro. On So Sunday. So Sunday. They go so crazy. How you grabbing your tummy? Hey. We got Cosby, Will, Martin, and the Wayans. This So Sunday. So you know they ain't playing off. It's so funny. Hey. On So Sunday. Oh, killing it. Hey, throw the jam in the back of that. Hey,
this man made his own theme song.
You know I'm coming with it. Tell somebody, hey, holla at me. All the other podcasts, hey, did they do that? Did they come up with the whole theme song?
I don't think
so. On Sundays? It's so fun. Nay. Look, we can say funny or Sunday. Either way. We got this.
Wow.
Hey. Yeah, step it up. Cosby, Will, Martin, and the Wayans. Hey, yeah, you can't beat that, bro. Cosby, what Will, Martin, and the Wayans. What you got, bro? Come on, so funny, all right. Bro.
So my list is actually very similar to your list.
I'm hoping so.
when I say very similar, I mean like we got the same shows except for one, which is in.
Okay.
I put Hanging with Mr. Cooper. Yeah.
Okay.
My list is actually very similar to yours, except for the Cosby Show for me. I'm gonna just say my list real quick. Hanging with Mr. Cooper was the first show. Cosby was the second show. Then Fresh Prince, and then Martin, for me.
I mean, so yeah, we think Great Mind thinks alike, bro. We think alike.
And of course, I went the easy way and I put Prime TV or Prime Saturday Night, whichever one y'all want to go with. You go with PTV or you go with PSN. Usually, it don't matter for me. I'm not going to create an own theme song because, you know, I done already did five of these blocks already. I'm out of steam.
So that was my main little reveal coming out, but hey, it is funny. We agree on the same shows. Those are the funny shows, bro.
Now, Now, do you have any honorable mention for, before we get to cartoons, you have any honorable mentions? You can go up to, let's see, we'll go up to three. We can do three honorable mentions.
So, for that block, or do, can I just do my off-color block, my off-white?
Yeah, you can do that. Yeah.
So I didn't name this one yet, but because you know, I got much love for my white brothers and sisters, so I just feel like they're just in a different category. Like they're just on Saturday, so I can watch them on Saturday. This is my so funny Sunday, but on Saturday, you know, and out of the, you know, some of these start with the S as well.
Okay.
We start off with Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
Ooh. Okay.
Then we got a Seinfeld.
Jerry Seinfeld. Yep.
And then I'm going to go Married with Children.
Ooh, Al Bundy. Yeah, that's a good one.
And then 2 1/2 Men. I didn't know if that was quite the same, but 2 1/2 Men is just...
Okay.
We're just going to end now, with that.
I could tell you, as far as the vibe of the show, that vibe goes from, like, good to teen to, like, outrageously adultish. So.
Yeah, but why do people get down like that? You know, they expose their children early. They know what's up.
Okay.
Shout out to y'all.
I wish I could have made... I mean, I was more focused on these other shows. I did not make one. If I had to just make one at the top of my head, just all the shows I know that I watch, I'd probably do, I don't know, Saved by the Bell, Full House...
Yeah, see, I miss Full House. I could have put that instead of Sabrina.
I don't know, Boy Meets World or Step by Step or something. I don't know. I tried, you know.
Yeah, I just put my that was a little secondary list. I could think about that. But look, I got y'all later.
You have any?
Y'all know the real list.
Oh wow! You have any ones that you want to do for your honorable mentions for the? So
for the main list, look, yeah. I mean, I had, look, Moesha was in there.
Okay, okay.
So I had Moesha mentioned. Oh, and then obviously, not obviously, but Jamie Foxx show.
Okay.
Ridiculous. So I almost had that one in there. And then also Family Matters. Matters and Jamie Foxx. Those are the two that were, I almost started off with my boy Urkel, you know, it was close. But how can you really X out Cosby? That's just not possible. It's just not possible. So I had to keep Cosby in there for the four block. But yeah, that and Jamie Foxx. And like I said, I felt good because he's at least in Living Color. So
okay. For me, I had Malcolm and Eddie, which is a very, very fun
underrated
show.
Very underrated, too.
Very, very underrated. But I was like, I already got Malcolm Jamal Warner in here already, so I might as well just maybe put it in my honorable mentions. But this show does not get enough credit. Like, I loved it. This is like my top five favorite shows. Black shows or any show. Well, black shows, you know. It's up there. That and Steve
Harvey. See, look, I need to go back because I need to watch shows like that again, because when you watch them when you're young, you only get but so much. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
so I would love to watch that again now because I love both of them brothers.
I would compare it to a Kenan and Kel, an adult Kenan and Kel, where they're both like, they don't have like, you know, like how Kel character was. They don't have any of that.
I need to check that out again.
That's a good comparison. Yeah, that's a good comparison.
No, for sure, Eddie Griffin as Kel, and then Malcolm Jamal as Kenan, right? Yeah. For sure.
Yep, and he had dreads too. But yeah, it's like I said, it's more adults. Like they talk about how many people they get. Yeah,
that might have been the reason why they got that show, bro. To be real, you never know.
My other show was Family Matters, which came in close. You know, I probably would have put this on my teen show too, but they went from past the teenage age. Like, they was like 20 or 22 or something when they left. So I was like, maybe I can't do it like that. Well, it did go like 10 years, so maybe. And my third show is The Wayans Brothers, because that show is so funny.
Oh, yeah. 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 I mean, obviously, like I said, and Living Color helped me get that one out of here, because I was able to include most of them. So, but yeah, Wayans Brothers, man, Pops, whew, he, every show. Papa always has
gotta, to we gotta, I wanna include.
Boy, don't be telling my business, boy.
I want to include this clip of Pops doing his song, My Love Goes Bang, Bang, Bang.
When my love goes bang, 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 you better run to cover your speed.
That song, oh my God.
Coordinating all the way to Wayans Brothers, bro. Killing it.
All right. Okay. All right. So we're almost to the end of these little box here. Actually, your list was good. My list was, well, I feel like it was good. The fans list was good.
What you mean? I mean, you had a 4 or 5 list, but we kind of knew we were going to have some crop. Yeah. So we had a lot of the same things. But, I mean, that just speaks to, you know, good knowledge and nostalgia, I guess. This is the Prime Nostalgia Podcast.
Yeah, yeah. This is the list of cartoons. As you can tell, when I read mine, I went a totally different way from cartoons. But, hey, we'll get into it. At first, I was going to do Saturday morning. But then I started thinking of the cartoons and the cartoons that I like. So I was like, yeah, I could probably put this for a nighttime show. So I put it for Thursday night. I just went simple. I just went happy hour. These are the happy hours. My number one show is Avatar: The Last Airbender. I'm starting to put some heat. For y'all that don't know, Avatar: The Last Airbender is probably one of the best cartoons known to man. I mean, you can have your opinions, but if we talk about fighting cartoons, then of course. We talk about regular what cartoons supposed to be, then I guess you have an argument. But I would say Avatar is one of the best cartoons, especially like fighting wise, which is a theme in this list. So my number two is X-Men: The Animated Series because.
Ooh, oh wait, well, see, yeah, wait, you coming out with the heat right now? Okay, I see where this list is going. Keep going.
This list is going. It's happy. We're still fighting, and it's happy. It's about to go dark because number three on my list is Gargoyles. So y'all don't know Gargoyles is basically crime fighting. Gargoyles that fight at night, but during the day they are like stone creatures or whatever. But yeah, that show is kind of dark. It's getting to the dark side. That's why I put this at night. And then number four just takes it all the way dark. We got Batman: The Animated Series. So I got light all the way to dark. I got the dark side, of course, and then went to Batman as the dark side. So I just went simple, called it a happy hour, and I went to the happy hour, then I went to the dark side of happy hour. I mean, I got honorable mentions. I might as well name them, too. I got one of my honorable mentions is Danny Phantom. He could probably be, like, at 7:30 or whatever. And then I got Darkwing Duck, which he's just, like, a regular cartoon. So he'd probably be at 7 o'clock or whatever. And then, that's just my list. I went a little light, then went dark, so...
All right, so look, I got a little light list right here because I'm more of a Saturday morning cartoon type of guy, but I did have a couple nighttime cartoons that I like. So, but first, I'm gonna start off with the classic because this is a low key dark, but it's it's still acceptable for the crowd. The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, man.
Okay.
Yeah, you can't, like, beat the four characters, blah, blah, blah. And then you got the rap, Splinter, and, it's just nonstop. It's as far as the Bebop, Rocksteady, and blah, blah, blah. So you got hella shit going on there. Then you got I got Daria.
Ooh,
that's a old. Okay. That just taught us the resting bitch face, right? where did she come from? So I don't even know exactly who she was, but I know I was addicted to that girl for no reason. Do you remember the show The Critic?
I heard of it, actually. Yes, I have heard of it.
So this guy would just talk about movies and live with roaches, and it was absolutely disgusting. But I used to watch it as a kid and thought I was an adult. And then this is another maybe... not so known classic, Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Ooh, okay. That's a good one. You got any honorable mentions?
For this one, you know what? I would throw out... What you got?
My honorable mentions, I put Danny Phantom and Darkwing Duck. Still in that
See, fight. I would be in the same Darkwing Duck, Gargoyles type bag.
Okay.
I like those. Just thinking about nighttime cartoons. Yeah, I got to do some more homework. I'll be ready.
Okay. All right. So, the last thing that we are going to do. Last thing I want to do is think of something we can do together. Okay? We both kind of got the same list. So, I want to do a joint list. We can put our ideas together. Even though we got the same ones, we can think of the position that they're going to go in. All right?
Yeah. Oh, so we're going to put it. Oh, okay. We're going to really finalize the whole list.
Right? Yes.
Let's finalize this block, bro, because I think we got something here. We got something strong. Okay. We're on the same. We're on the same page. Let's just close the book. Let's do it.
I put Hanging with Mr. Cooper first. What would you start out with?
Hanging with Mr. Cooper. See, I would just argue ahead of that. I think Family Matters is just a little bit more kind of. If I wanted to have that first family show, because we both thought about Family Matters too.
Yes.
So I guess it's going to be between our first show and then our last. Obviously, I have In Living Color at the end. So the other three we agree with.
Yes. Yep.
So are we going to replace this first one or are we going to replace that last one?
Ooh. You know what?
So we agree on Cosby, Fresh Prince, and Martin.
Yes.
Ooh, so we're going to start it off with something sweet or end it off with something.
Okay. All right. So is this like a. Are we putting Fresh Prince and Martin in the middle? Like, are those two for sure going 2 and 3?
Well, you have Martin last. So I think I can acquiesce and have Martin last.
Okay, so Martin
should replace this first one with either we go with Mr. Cooper or we go with, I think Family Matters. I know that wasn't on either one of our lists, but what do you think, so Mr. Cooper?
You're really adamant on putting Family Matters in, okay?
So Hang on Mr. Cooper. Obviously, that's another strong comedian leading the show, so I'm all for that. And then also, I got my homie Marquise Wilson, who was the next door neighbor in that show. Love the show. Mark Curry, he's a Bay Area legend, been around in the game for years, and somebody just stole his joke recently, right? He was complaining about that. Steve Harvey, we didn't even say the Steve Harvey show.
I was going to put that as my honorable mention, but the Wayans brothers beat it out.
I don't know if I can have Cooper in there, man.
Okay. So you want to put Family in there.
What do you think? Is Urkel or Cooper?
Now, for me, watching both shows, the Hanging with Mr. Cooper is funny. It's still funny now, but in the 90s, I'm sure it killed. So, like, maybe they got more jokes of that time. So maybe it would give Family Matters a slight edge in being timeless.
I think I don't know if I convinced you, but that's what I would vote. So, I did forget about Raven Simone for a second. So shout out to her and Cooper.
Yep.
But can we please slide that one in? Can we go Family Matters, Cosby, Fresh Prince, then Martin? Ooh, boy. I don't know if they can beat that one. I'm not trying to... What else we thinking now?
Let me put it to you like this. This is the so-so funny, right?
Sundays.
Yes, I'm going to break it off of that, all right? Is so-so funny. What show on here is the least funniest to you?
Damn, I would say... Maybe Family Matters.
Okay.
Obviously, my first instinct was to say Cosby, but if you just look at Cosby, he has such classic moments that are like beyond time, bro. Beyond time.
Without even saying anything, his facial expressions as well.
Right. So That would have been my first instinct, but you can't even go there. So I would have to, unfortunately, put Jaleel White as the least funny.
Okay.
Of those, but Urkel in general, bro. Come on now. Urkel yes. is funny as hell, and then Urkel, like, come on. He got in the time in the smoke machine and became Urkel, whatever his last name was. Stefan
Urkel.
Oh, Stefan Urkel?
Stefan Urkel, yeah.
That's ridiculous. And then don't forget Waldo. Was that his homie name?
Yeah, Waldo was Eddie's friend.
Eddie's homie, yeah.
And then you had Myra, which is Michelle Thomas, rest in peace. Right.
And then they used to do some like just classic dancing, and there were some good elements in that show that are just timeless, because that was a huge blended family. So that just like kind of related to a lot of people that just had a lot of people in their house.
and they adopted what's his name? 3J, I believe that's his name. Orlando Brown. Yep.
I think I auditioned for that for sure. For sure, 3J. And then obviously Urkel was just next door, and I always loved that because you didn't never see his parents, and then until like one episode, so it was just like a crazy blended family. They had some high. Remember when they went to high school? And, man, I think that's in there. That's just me.
Yeah, no, they had some serious moments on there as well, like. It's comedy, but like it's a drama as well, you know. Episode like Eddie got shot in one of them. Eddie got racially profiled by one of them.
Right.
One of them, I think they used a hard ER in the show. I think they wrote it on their locker or something.
I'm sure. Yeah. I'm sure. And then I mean, obviously, and then Pops was a cop, so he had his whole like dealing with the department episodes and.
Yep.
And then, obviously, the mom, she was a professional, too, as well, right? And then she became a homemaker?
No, she was a elevator, like, I don't know what you call it, where you sit in the elevator and you press the number for people.
So she was like, yeah, she felt disparaged or whatever.
Because technically, this is a spinoff show. Technically.
Break it down.
So... Harriet, the mom, was on this show called Perfect Strangers, where she worked in their wherever they live at, or whatever. And she was the elevator maid. So they made a spinoff of her and her family, which in the first season, it was supposed to be about them two. Supposed to be about them and their family, but then, like, Steve Urkel came and stole the show. So then they started, like, more writing stuff for Urkel. And then, you know, you took over.
He just kept pulling his pants up. Like, what you gonna do? His pants is up to his nipples, like you can't beat that.
Well, he was only supposed to come in to do like maybe one or two episodes or whatever. And the story that Jaleel White tells is that it was like this college group of college kids chanting his name Urkel. And I guess the studio was like, all right, we're gonna keep him. So hey.
That's what I'm saying. Look, Urkel, Cosby, Will, Martin, woo, he so
that's what we're going with? Are these the four we locking in?
It's so, so funny on So, So Sunday. Hey. Ooh, throw that funky track in the back. Ooh, we got one. Hey, if y'all, anybody needs some producing, any help on any of these networks, let me know. Lee Boy's here for your help.
Hey, I might be able to get you a little beat for that.
Yep.
All right. So funny. We got Family Matters, Cosby, Fresh Prince, and Martin. We locking this in.
I'm ready. Okay. Like it.
All right, done deal. We gonna lock this in. This is our block. So funny. On Sundays.
Sunday.
All right. Hey, that was a nice episode, man. That was pretty good. Let everybody know where they can find you.
Man, find me on Instagram, Leeboy Magic. That's the number one way. If not, just Google me, Leon Frierson. I'm Leon Leeboy Frierson from all that. And I'm just out here trying to have a good time on the Prime Nostalgia Podcast.
Hey. All right. Well. Hey, we are coming. Not coming to the end. We are at the end of the road. We did all these shows, all these blocks. Thank you to the people that commented on Twitter. To the people that didn't comment on Instagram, let me stop. I'm not going to even go there. Nah, seriously, though. Thank you to the people. Thank you for listening. Even if you got this far, thank you because we had Shaddai. I ain't know it's going to be this long, but we got discussion. We got our perfect block, so that's good.
We hashed it out.
I still think Malcolm and Eddie should go at 7:30, but we'll probably do that later at a later time.
I'm gonna have to watch a few of those. We can talk about it later for sure. But for now,
we got our block. For now, we locked in the So So Funny Sunday, Family Matters, Cosby Show, Fresh Prince, and Martin. Martin is our closer. Come on now.
Killing it.
Oh my God. All right.
Whole Bad Boys
crew. Yeah. Yeah. For real. So, guys, that was the Prime Nostalgia Podcast. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at KVNG Primetime. Get involved. I'm trying to get more involved on social media because, you know, I guess it's fun, you know. But yeah. And if you have any blocks, comment them down below as well because. We might even revisit this just to read other people's comments, you know. We might even revisit this so we can have a more discussion on it.
Oh, yeah, that's anyways, the first draft. We ready for part two. Let's
do it. Oh, yeah. Anyways, guys, from me, from Leon, prime time is all the time. To you.